All right, let's get going this morning. Let's go ahead and recognize our elected officials. Carmichael, who is recently resigned, running for chairman. Glad to have you, and Todd Conell. Is anybody else here? All right, let's get going. Boy, let's show them some prayer this morning.
Let me pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day, and thank you for all the many blessings you bestowed upon us. Dear Father, thank you for this season of year, and help us to be mindful of those around us in need. Dear Father, thank you for the men and women who stand guard to protect our freedoms around this world, around the world, and through this country. We pray for those victims in France, dear Father, and we pray for leadership in this country. We pray that you would be with us and guide us, that your will would be done. We ask for your wisdom. We ask for your peace in all the things that we do. In your name, in the name of Jesus, I pray.
Amen.
All righty. I want to hear the minutes from last month, October 21st.
Make a motion with you.
Second.
All in favor?
Abstain.
All righty. Anybody got any questions about the financial statement?
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, who's going to do the FPO report this morning? Joe here?
No, Joe had a lot of fuel come in this morning, so he wasn't able to make it over. The numbers for October in terms of operations are 380 operations. That's up a bit from September. It is down a little bit over this time last year, but I think that they had a military operation that came in that wasn't able to do all they needed to do because of the weather. And of course, everybody knows it's rained every other day for the last month and a half, so it has placed a bit of a damper on the operations on the fuel cells out at the airport. That's nothing that's been any of our control. So.
Did he? I thought he was trying to figure out a way to speed up that fuel.
He is working on a couple different alternatives to try to be able to pump the fuel faster for the military aircraft, which require that.
All right, let's move right on into your report there, Blake.
All right, I'm going to discuss the environmental hearing that's set for December the 1st. Been working very, very, very closely with FAA over the last couple of weeks on this environmental assessment. We have made a couple of changes since I reported to you last month. One of those changes is we are moving the hearing from the terminal building over to the corporate hangar. There was a concern that there might not be enough room in the terminal building since it only holds about 200 people or so in our largest meeting room. So we are going to move that over to the corporate hangar. Corporate hangar is 25,000 square feet. It's probably the largest open space in any building in the county, so we can accommodate several thousand people if that many people happen to show up. I don't really think there'll be that many there, but nonetheless, that building has capacity to accommodate as many people that feasibly could attend. So that's the first change. The second change is that we are going to have a portion of the time set aside for people to make public comments. So originally the idea was that the comments would be made to the court reporters and that they would be written down and would be submitted in a written format or given directly to the court reporter. So that has changed. We will still have both of those options. So we still will have the option to give your comment to the court reporter. You'll still have a comment or option to write it down and hand it to someone, but you'll also have the option, if you want to speak publicly, to get up and do that. So those are a couple changes that have been made.
Yes, but we're going to have a time limit.
A time limit on
public speaking?
There'll be a time limit on the amount of time an individual can speak.
Right.
But in terms of a time limit for the entire public input portion, no.
No, I just didn't know if individuals, if we...
Yes, individuals will have a time limit. But as many people that want to show up and speak will accommodate as many people who want to show up and speak. So if we're there till 10, that's fine. If we're there till 2 a.m., that's fine. Any questions on those changes with the hearing?
Where are you going to be able to get all these chairs and stuff that way?
We're going to have to bring some rental chairs in. We've got about 220 or so chairs in the terminal building, so of course we'll have to bring over what chairs we've got, and then we'll probably pick up another couple hundred from your rental location.
And how many restrooms you got in that hangar? You got
Two.
You got two?
Two restrooms, yes. So go to the bathroom before you come to the hearing.
Will there be water and refreshments out there, I mean, or anything like that, I mean?
I don't know if we're, that's a good question, I haven't honestly given that much thought, so that's something I'll look into and get back with you.
Especially when they're 2 a.m., you know? Okay.
Opportunity for a vending machine.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, has anybody got any questions about that? Let's move on, please. Go ahead and make a comment.
All righty, wanted to make sure, I know I've sent all of you an electronic copy of the economic impact study, and I'm not going to go into great detail on this today. The first thing that I wanted to do was thank the chamber for putting this together. This is something that we've heard over and over and over from the public, is, you know, has there been an economic impact study done? Has there been an economic impact study done? So the answer now is yes, there has been an economic impact study done. What we did originally, as all of you know, because we talked about this in a lot of detail, is we went out and looked at economic impact studies that were done at other airports that we thought were very, very similar to the operation that we wanted to set up. So we just simply looked at the information that was already available. Now we have a specific document that's been created specifically for our airport, which tells what the economic impact is expected to be in terms of job creation, in terms of GDP, and in terms of economic output. So all those numbers are in here. I'm not going to go through and read it to you. If you haven't had an opportunity to look at it yet, I would encourage you to take a look through it. I think the numbers are very impressive. Quite honestly, these numbers are a little bit higher than what I even anticipated. So
it is on our website.
Yeah, and I think we're going to try to get it on our website as well. So Carolyn did send me an electronic copy, so I think we're going to try to get it up on our website as well. We do want the public to have this information as well. Any questions on the economic impact study?
Me? Kind of briefly, tell me what it looks like, as far as where are we at?
Sure, I can just give you a quick synopsis of the summary. Combined total economic impact is new and expanded air services, which include the impact of airport-related operations, visitor spending, and all indirect and induced economic impacts estimated to be 122, what they call person years, which are jobs, and approximately 13 million in economic output in year one. So that is just the economic impact that's anticipated to be in year one. It goes up from there in subsequent years.
Right. Will you tell about the company that is Intervistas?
Well, I can tell you what I know about Intervistas, which is not a whole lot, but this is their primary business. They do economic impact studies. They're a massive, massive company. They're international. They do economic impact studies for airports ranging from our size all the way up to, you know, airports the size of Hartsfield, and they do them for airports around the world. So this is their primary, one of their primary businesses is doing these types of studies.
And they were hired by the chamber?
Yes.
We were compared to Concord, North Carolina, and Rickenbacker Airport in outside of Columbus, Ohio. Rickenbacker.
What was that other one there, Carolyn, besides Concord?
Rickenbacker Airport.
Northeast of Ohio.
Okay, has anybody got anything else for Blake on the impact?
No, in the study, they make reference to other airports that they used to kind of compare us to. Concord, Rickenbacker, Youngstown, Warren Regional Airport, and St. Cloud Regional Airport. So there are a number of airports that they looked at to take economic data from. And they did look specifically at Allegiant's operations, so they looked at you know, the type of operations that we would have. So obviously they're trying to compare apples to apples, which is what we want. So.
All right, very good. That's it. All righty, need a motion now to go into closed session, discuss personnel, real estate, and litigation.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, I move to re-in a regular session and report that no action was taken in executive session.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we got three people that need to be added to y'all's agenda that didn't get on there. Lenny Backman, KB Coggins, and Lynn Joe. And here's the rule. You got 5 minutes. Tom will call for you when you have 1 minute left. So just keep your eyes on Tom there before the end. Make sure they're going to go 5 minutes. But anyway, so Lenny Backman.
Where would you like us to speak from?
It doesn't matter anywhere you want.
How about right here?
That'd be fine.
Well, thank you for the time to speak, Commissioner, as well as all the members of the board. I have a few questions or statements I would like to make about the environmental assessment meeting that's going on on the 1st. I live in Post 1, and I have probably talked to close to 100 people in our post. A number of them are pro-airport, a number of them are opponent-airport. But a number of them have also said and asked the question, why is the meeting being held at the airport? It's very biased to the general public. Another question is, why aren't we using a neutral location? One of the high schools, Chattahoochee Tech, even the lunchroom downstairs on the first floor. And then, as one, two, three people said, if the airport is good enough place to hold the EA, why does the board meet in the board commission room? Some of the other comments is, will this be a town hall meeting where people will be able to ask questions? Will the public get honest response to those who wrote the EA and not just, we'll have to look into that? The next question is why are we holding the EA? There are a number of lawsuits still pending for the airport. Why are we wasting all taxpayer money, whether it be the federal level, the state level, or the county level, until these lawsuits are resolved? And last but not least, and I think Blake answered this earlier today, will the opponents of the 139 be giving people space to tell their part of the story during this meeting? Thank you for your concern.
Thank you. All righty.
At the Paulding County Airport Authority meeting held on May the 20th, 2015, a motion was made and passed to refund the fuel flow fee to the promoter of the air show. The amount was undetermined, but was estimated to be between $2,500 and $3,000. Over the next 6 months, I have had several conversations with Mr. Squawker, and during this time filed several open records requests as it relates to the fuel flow fee. During a conversation last month, I was advised by Blake that he did not refund the fuel flow fee to the air show promoter as the motion required, but rather gave it to the Board of Education because the promoter had not paid the Board of Education for their services and the check was for a little over $6,000. I did not think this was proper, since this was in direct conflict with a motion that was made and passed by this airport authority. Blake emphatically stated that he had spoken to each and every one of y'all on this matter, and that he had the authority to write checks up to $10,000 without any. Many of y'all. Our open meeting clause and Robert's Rules of Order does not permit an employee to override what this body duly voted on and passed. It must be brought back to this body to be amended or changed in an open meeting. Anything less than that circumvents the citizen's right to know what the authority is spending money on and how much is being spent. An open records request revealed that Blake Walford was billed on May 21st from the Board of Education $13,250.03 for the airport shuttle and paid that amount in two separate checks on June the 15th and November the 10th. This is in violation of the Intergovernmental Agreement, the IBA Agreement, and the motion passed by the Airport Authority and needs to be corrected immediately. On 10/23, I did an open record request to all members of the Airport Authority, Mr. David Austin, Mr. Carmichael, and Blake Swalper, in regard to the July 17, 2012 letter written by Mr. Swalper. I asked two questions, that and what the fuel flow fee was being paid to the PCA, and I received the following response. Thank you for your open record request to the Pawnee County Airport Authority. The authority has reviewed your request and does not have any documents that are responsive to the items in number one and two, which dealt with what I just said. I find it unbelievable that Mr. Swalper took it upon himself prior to July the 17th, 2012, to contact the FAA in regard to Part 139 certification, contact with Allegiant Air in regard to Part 121 Air Service, and the TSA in regard to the security of commercial passenger service without the consent of the Airport Authority or the Chairman of the Board of Commissioners. Furthermore, it's very unlikely that some of these either have responded in any manner to you, Mr. Swalper. The Pawnee County Airport Authority or the Chairman of the County Commissioner letter itself indicates differently. I request the open record request dated October 23rd, 2015, item one, be reviewed again by all parties, including counsel, and other responses be given from parties, all parties involved. In regards to the fuel flow fee, it is improper to allow the PCAA to receive the fee. All money that has been received should be paid back to the IBA promptly. Thank you very much.
Okay. All right, Linda Joe. Introduce yourself to us.
Good morning. I'm Linda Jo Nari. I am the Vice President of Business Development for Imagineer. I have some good news, exciting news that we think for the county. Imagineer is on-demand air taxi service that provides fast and reliable service to business and leisure travelers. Through our partnership with the Paulding Jet Center at the Paulding Northwest Atlanta Airport, we're proud to offer more travel options to the community with short air travel as an option over long drives. Local and regional travelers now have the opportunity to access over 500 regional airports from the Paulding Jet Center facility, turning a 3 to 8 hour drive into a 1 to 2 hour direct flight. We're very excited about this opportunity to work with the folks there at the Paulding Jet Center and the airport, really trying to help turn the airport into a transportation gateway for the community. People will be able to come out and get on a small airplane and go where they need to go. It's a quality of life, be able to go, have their business meeting, and get back home. And again, I want to stress this is an on-demand air taxi service. It is not a scheduled service.
And when you say small, what do you mean by small?
We have a fleet of Cirrus SR-22 aircraft. With a pilot, they can take up to 3 other passengers. Normally, it's a 1 to 2 passengers that are in the aircraft.
Thank you, Linda Joe. I've been with y'all before. Y'all do a great job.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I recommend. All right. Any questions or comments?
Council might ought to study that the reason why there has to be a hearing for the DA is it is a requirement of federal law, and the reason the DA was done was in settlement or in agreement with the settlement. You may be able to use the correct words, but that's what predicated the necessity of the EVA and the hearing that is commensurate with it.
That's correct. The environmental assessment was a part of a resolution. One of the lawsuits that you discussed, part of that settlement required the environmental assessment. And it's my understanding in FAA's regulations, when there is an environmental assessments of that type. There's a public hearing component, so the purpose of it is to allow for public input at that hearing.
You might ask.
I'm left to adjourn.
Sorry. All in favor?
All right.
What is that?